What will you do for love? Fight an army, kill, go through hell. One man did. To see his wife and meet his child, a man agrees to become the nemesis of God. Hello, and welcome to Films and Series Recap. Today, we will be exploring a film from 1997 called Spawn. In this comic book adaptation, among the first and one of the few with an African-American as the main character, we will watch the story of a tragic hero. After watching this video, you may find yourself asking the following question: what would you be willing to give to see the person you love again? Feel free to like, subscribe, share, comment on whether you enjoyed it. Give your recommendations, and let me know if you felt compelled to watch the film. The film begins with a monologue. A secret war is happening between heaven and hell. To feed his army, the devil uses humans to spread death and chaos on Earth, in exchange for wealth, to swell the ranks of the forces of evil. One element is missing: the general who will lead this army and bring about the apocalypse. Our story starts in a military airport in Hong Kong. A commando, consisting of a single man, infiltrates a control tower. After killing everyone present, he launches a guided missile at a jet containing an Arab dignitary and his entire family, before causing a massive explosion. On the side, a strange man observes. This is Al Simmons, our protagonist. Later, at the CIA headquarters, his boss, Jason Wynn, observes his actions on the news. Wynn works with the forces of hell. He sends his commandos on missions to destabilize nations and spread chaos, ostensibly for humanitarian reasons. They now ask him to provide them with Al Simmons, their best soldier. Meanwhile, Al returns home. We meet his wife, Wanda, pregnant with their child, and his colleague and best friend, Terry. Terry shows him the news. His attack yesterday made headlines. It was, in reality, an attack on innocence. He confronts Wynn about his lies and resigns. Wynn tries to convince him, showing his record. He's a killing machine, the best ever seen. This doesn't convince Sal, weary of killing, but he accepts one last mission to destroy a dangerous factory that created a deadly virus. On the day of the mission, he alone manages to penetrate the heavily guarded fortress. But inside, he discovers soldiers already dead and a detonator. Wynn appears. They plan to explode the factory, despite the nearby city, to test this new virus. Al tries to stop him, but is ambushed by his henchman, the dangerous priest. Injured, he covers him in a flammable substance, burns him alive, and triggers the explosion of the factory. Al is dead, and his soul is sent to hell. During his descent, he screams his wife's name, Wanda. On a rainy night, in a dirty alley, on the roof of a church, Al wakes up. His skin is charred like that of a severe burn victim, and he is in great pain. His outward appearance frightens people. A man, Cogliostro, tries to help him, but Al refuses. Cogliostro's been watching him for a long time. Al doesn't know it, but 5 years have passed since the factory accident. The Lord of Darkness has kept him captive all these years to stoke his anger. Al returns home. When he arrives, it's his daughter's birthday party, whom he has never known. The love of his life, Wander, is now happy, affectionately kissing Terry, his best friend. Al doesn't understand, and still suffers from his resurrection. He is surprised by his daughter, who takes him for a homeless person, but helps him anyway. At the sight of him, his wife is frightened and even protects their daughter from him. She doesn't recognize him. The obese clown who animated the party arrives and takes care of Al. He brings him back to the alley where the homeless live, the Rat Street. He is actually a demon beneath his clown appearance. He enjoys annoying and torturing Al, who still suffers physically.
Look at that. Skid marks.
And psychologically, he teaches him that his pains come from the necroplasm, a power from hell that is emerging in him. He also informs him that he is dead and buried. He shows him his past. At his death, he went to hell. Malebolgia, a demon god, made him an offer: lead his army in exchange for the chance to see one again. He accepted. His mission on Earth is now to kill Jason Wynn. The clown continues to feed Al's anger towards his wife, friends, daughter, and Wynn.
Girl, do it like this.
Alvin realizes that his body is stronger, and a black exoskeleton emerges from his body. It's his spawn from hell costume. The clown is there to make sure he completes his transformation. He leaves Al ready to take revenge on Wynn. Cogliostro then appears. He was a spawn like him, a dead knight, but that was more than 500 years ago. He hopes to convince Al to avoid the path of vengeance, but he refuses and leaves. Cogliostro then pulls out a sword. He is ready to kill him to prevent the victory of hell. In the CIA offices, Wynn observes the information reporting the results of his atrocities. His virus, released 5 years ago, is the most virulent there is, and only he has the remedy. He is now preparing to deploy it to the world. Outside, Al has infiltrated the CIA offices. A huge red cape seems to appear and disappear from his body. He raids their ammunition and arms heavily.
Time to get reacquainted, Jason.
Terry, on the other hand, demands answers from Wynn. He is their spokesperson, but wants to investigate some dubious CIA missions. Wynn threatens his family if he pokes around where he shouldn't. He invites him to join him at a gala, where the most powerful warlords in the world are gathered. Following Malebolgia's plans, Spawn infiltrates the gala and threatens Wynn.
You don't recognize your own handiwork.
He also confronts Derry, whose own daughter now calls him Daddy. He recognizes his old friend and is shocked. When about to kill Wynn, he is attacked by Priest, who shoots him multiple times. He then realizes that his wounds are regenerating. He faces Priest and kills her. The clown appears, proud of his protege. Wynn's personal army arrives and forces him to flee. He unconsciously develops his powers, like chains coming out of him, the power to stick to walls, or even a conscious cape that allows him to become invisible and fly. After his escape, Wynn confronts the clown about their double cross. He gaslights him that Al must complete a mission, then he will belong to hell. They also connect Wynn's heart to a detonator that will release the virus worldwide if he stops. During the night, Al returns to spy and wander and encounters his daughter. Strangely, she is not afraid of him. Al, now calling himself Spawn, returns to the church where he came back to life to take shelter. He protects a young child, Zack, who had helped him when he woke up. They are interrupted by the clown. Spawn knows he is colluding with Wynn and that they orchestrated his death. He does not deny it. They manipulated Al's bloodline for centuries to create the perfect killer. Al refuses to follow him to kill Wynn. The two clash, and the obese clown transforms into an immense kaiju several meters tall, the Violator. Spawn attacks him with his multiple firearms, but with little effect. The fight continues in alleys filled with homeless people. Despite its size, the monster is extremely fast and easily takes the upper hand. He ends up crucifying Spawn. The Violator resumes his human form and warns Spawn that it will either be Wynn or taken care of Wanda. Cogliostro reappears and frees Spawn. He is about to kill him, but he sees that he has not yet turned to Hell's side. Terry, on the other hand, has infiltrated Wynn's office after learning that he had Al executed. He now has concrete evidence against him. Cogliostro explains to Spawn that he now has a choice between serving good or evil, but Al Simmons is dead. In any case, he must take down the clown. He indicates that firearms will be useless against him. With great ease, he activates the Spawn costume. As a former Spawn himself, he tells him that his armor is alive and can create anything if he focuses on it. He is not, however, immortal. If his head is cut off, he will die. Spawn abandons his weapons and goes on a motorcycle to find the clown at Wynn's. On the way, he is attacked by a surprise from him, ramming him with a garbage truck. Spawn transforms, via his cape, the motorcycle into an armored version. Then he defeats the clown by impaling the truck with his cape. The truck explodes, but the clown is still unharmed and flies away. He gives him an appointment at Wanda's place. At her house, Terry shares the stolen information with the media. But as he turns around, he sees his family taken hostage by Wynn. They are then joined by the clown, Later, Spawn arrives. He discovers Wynn threatening Wanda. He tells him to join Hell or be killed. Spawn refuses, and Wynn kills Wanda with a smile. He provokes him, and Spawn, devastated, attacks him. He warns him that if he kills him, the virus will be released. But Spawn has no more interest in Earth and humans. Hell rejoices at the imminent arrival of their future general. Wynn then indicates that if he kills him, it will kill his daughter. Before the finishing blow, after a glance at her, he stops. With his powers, he removes the detonator and, respecting his last human wish, refuses to kill him. The dead body of Wanda then wakes up and attacks him with unparalleled strength. She manages to cut his throat. She turns out to be the transformed clown. He screams at Spawn to kill Wynn, but he refuses. Wynn understands that he was only used to certify Spawn's allegiance to Hell. He is about to push him further by revealing the real Wanda. She is then saved by Cogliostro, who attacks him with his magic sword. It genuinely hurts the creature, which flees into the fireplace flames. Cogliostro frees Wanda, and urges Spawn to concentrate on healing, unable to defeat him alone. He reveals an ancient armor, and prepares for the clown's return. They are then all transported by the clown to Hell. Cogliostro fights the clown in his Violator form, but is quickly defeated. Spawn intervenes and, despite the difficulties, manages to land a decisive blow to the enemy. He is then faced with his army and the Lord of Darkness. He rejects his offer. The Lord then sends his army to kill him after his refusal. Spawn saves Cogliostro and, with the necroplasm, manages to bring them back to Earth. Terry thanks them. Spawn frees himself from his anger, seeing the new loving family that Wanda has built. As everyone rests, Violator's hands reach through the wall and grab Spawn. In an intense scene, Violator prepares to eliminate Spawn by devouring his head. But he reacts quickly, creating an indestructible helmet. Using his chains, Spawn skillfully beheads the monster. Violator is defeated. Before his last breath, Spawn tells him to inform his boss that he is next. Later, the police and journalists surround the house. Jason Wynn is arrested, and Terry explains his secret malfeasance to the world. The film ends in an alley where Cogliostro observes the sky, proud of his new protector, and above a church, Spawn, in full control of his powers, watches over. The end. I love doing this video. Please tell me what did you think about it, or recommend new movies to explore. I read all the comments. Subscribe, and see you soon on Films and Series Recap. Goodbye.